All the Super Bowl ads, that's the one that just got me. And I know it got a lot of people, a lot of moms, a lot of dads, a lot of people who love girls, everyone that loves girls. You might remember that ad. It debuted right around the Super Bowl, aired during the Super Bowl. And it's about adolescent girls quitting sports largely due to body confidence. A new study shows, get this, 40% of girls and women feel pressured to change the way they look based on what they see on the darn phones. If they know the images are AI generated, it doesn't even matter. So we're gonna talk about this today. I'm excited to talk about this because it's such an important thing. Child and teen psychologist Dr. Sarah Paper is here, and she's here to talk about, you know, what it all means. And those numbers are startling. And right. It's not just the numbers, because I think a lot of moms out there and dads out there are noticing that their girls are peeling away from these activities prior to them really not even giving the activity a chance. Right. Doesn't matter what it is, dance, sports, arts, anything. And it's just because they don't think they can do it. The confidence level is in the basement. Mm-hmm. What is happening? Why is this happening?
There has been, Dove is doing great work with focusing on beauty standards and kind of changing how we see beauty and what's beauty. But again, there's this huge emphasis on beauty. And so what young girls are looking at too in their social media, it's beauty. Beauty products, beauty influencers, clothing, makeup, skincare, and that becomes a bigger part of their identity and what's valued. And then the idea of posting too. So we have parents who are posting pictures of their daughters participating in sports, and then they're focused on how they look. And we all kind of do that. We look back at the pictures and say, how did I look in this picture? Was I pretty enough? How did my body look?
So why is this dangerous?
This is dangerous because it's not what's important. We're teaching our girls and women, we're believing it too, that our value comes from how we look. Beauty is the most important thing we can achieve. One of the Dove studies said that a good percentage of women would give up 5 years of their life in order to meet the thin ideal standard.
No.
That's their life. Instead of living their life, they want to be thin in their life. They want to be attractive in their life. And us as women, the first thing we comment on often when we see each other and the girls is, oh, you look really pretty. Oh, I like your hair. I like what you're wearing. I like your lipstick. And so we're saying the most important thing and the thing I see about you is how you look. And that's what matters
most. So it's really just affecting them in every way. They're being bombarded by it every day. Mm-hmm. Even if it's AI, they don't even care that it's AI. They probably know it's AI. And then, so what do we do? What do we do? I have a 16-year-old. Yeah. I grew up struggling with it too. Mm-hmm. What do we do?
The first thing we can do as women and as mothers is to start talking about ourselves in different ways. The Dove research also showed that the biggest influence on girls' self-esteem and body image was what their mothers said about themselves. If the mom said, I don't like my eyes, the daughter would actually change her answer to, I don't like my eyes. And so we can start, modeling that positivity, but also neutrality. And so not talking about bodies as much as far as their shape, as far as their appearance, but rather their function. And so to focus on that you're strong, you're capable, you're smart, you're funny.
And prioritizing family time, how does that help?
Yeah, if we can spend more time doing things as a family, that's less time on your phone.
Okay, and, so that's just that's just a simple fact.
Simple, because you can't be staring at your phone if you're playing kickball in the backyard.
Yep.
And then you have your daughter focusing on what her body's doing. Then that's important.
And I think over the last few months, a lot of girls have looked at Caitlin Clark and looked at other people that are in the WNBA, and they're like, hey, wait a minute. This woman is amazing, and she's strong, and she has tenacity, and look what she's done. And that's what you have to do. You have to point out people like these people, like Simone Biles and people like that. You have to point them out, right?
Right. Sit with your daughter and go through her Instagram or her Snapchat or her TikTok and help her see who she's following and why. What does she admire about them? If it's only appearance, maybe we can take that person out and put in somebody you admire for other reasons.
Oh my goodness. You know, it's a lifelong challenge, I think. You know, for you, for me, for our kids, for our grandkids, for everyone. But I really appreciate you coming on because, you know, it's never been more important. And the fact is these phones are literally surgically attached to their hands these days. And so getting them out of their hands, but getting it out of their mind is the most important thing, right?
The most important thing, yeah. If it's out of their hands, then they're putting less in their mind. But if we can help them look at it differently, if they are looking at it, and get them engaged in other activities and focus on the other things about them other than their beauty.
Sports, music.
Yes.
Job, something.
Something.
Volunteering.
Anything.
All that stuff. All right, we have a lot of work to do, but we appreciate you because you helped us kind of put a spotlight on it. That's what we need. We have a link to Alina Health on KARE11.com where you can find out more if you're struggling with this. Thanks for coming on.
Thank you so much for having me.
All right, coming up.